President-elect Marcos seeks the help of Congress at curbing corruption in government. Senate Majority Leader Juan Miguel Zubiri says Marcos wants lawmakers to craft laws that would plug leakages in revenue-generating agencies like the Bureau of Internal Revenue, but ask if lawmakers will go after the Marcos family's estate tax liability worth 203 billion pesos. On top of their ill-gotten wealth, this is what Zubiri had to say.
No comment na lang ako dyan. And moving on na tayo. Election issue yan. Eh. Abos na election.
President-elect Marcos is said to be considering more allies of President Duterte as additions to his new cabinet. Incoming Press Secretary Trixie Cruz Angeles says Marcos may ask former House Deputy Speaker Rodante Marculeta to join his administration. Former Public Works Undersecretary Karen Jimeno and newspaper columnist Rigoberto Tiglao are also on Marcos's short list. Cruz Angeles says Marcos has yet to decide what specific posts to give them. The Marcos cabinet members who've already been named started working on the turnover from their predecessors.
The only directive is to work with the transition teams and to begin the familiarization and transfers. So very cooperative na. This is in accordance dun sa sinabi ni Presidente Duterte, forming the transition teams for each of the agencies.
Outgoing Philippine Tourism Chief Bernadette Romulo Puyat is named Deputy Governor of the country's central bank. Banco Central Governor Benjamin Diokno confirmed Puyat's appointment Wednesday. Puyat issued a statement thanking the Monetary Board for the opportunity and trust given to her. Puyat adds that as a trained economist, she looks forward to taking on her new role. Puyat was appointed Tourism Secretary in 2018 by President Duterte.
Bloggers may soon join their mainstream media counterparts in covering the incoming Marcos presidency. Incoming Press Secretary Trixie Cruz Angeles, who herself is a vlogger, says giving bloggers Malacanang press accreditation will be among her top priorities. But her plan is met with concern from a group of Philippine journalists.
We are very cautious and wary of the proposal given the context of the disinformation campaign launched by the Marcos Jr.'s camp during the election period. We have seen how these vloggers have been peddling lies and not verifying the statements of the president-elect. Journalists are different from bloggers. Our role is to fact-check. Our role is to publish verified information.
The Malacanang Press Corps says it will defer comment on the matter until more details are provided.
Philippine President-elect Marcos urges the Supreme Court to dismiss a petition seeking to cancel his candidacy. The petition was filed by civic leaders led by Father Christian Buenafe. Marcos says the Supreme Court no longer has jurisdiction over the case. He points out that the Presidential Electoral Tribunal is the sole judge of all disputes over the election and qualifications of the president. Supreme Court magistrates sit as members of the Electoral Tribunal in deciding election contests. Marcos's lawyer Estelito Mendoza earlier argued the High Court has no jurisdiction to stop the canvassing and the proclamation of the winner in the 2022 presidential race.
Outgoing senators bid farewell to the upper chamber on the last day of session for the 18th Congress. They are Senate President Vicente Soto III and Senators Panfilo Lacson, Manny Pacquiao, and Kiko Pangilinan. They all ran for higher posts in this year's elections, but lost.
I have one final and earnest appeal to the incoming 19th Congress. Maintain the integrity and the independence of the Senate. Huwag ninyong payagan na mabahira ng politika ang inyong serbisyo sa taong bayan.
I have gone full circle in this lifetime. I am finally going home and allow the evolution of our country's long line of legislators to take its course. Goodbye and good luck to my dear friends and colleagues.
I will continue learning and equipping myself so that I can give more to our country. Patuloy po akong magsisilbi sa anumang paraan. nasa posisyon man ako, wala.
Also leaving the Senate, Minority Leader Franklin Drilon, Richard Gordon, who failed to get re-elected, and Ralph Recto, who will move to the lower house after running unopposed as Batangas 6th District Representative.
Dumating na po tayo sa punto na kailangan natin magpaalam. Pero pansamantala lang. Ika nga, a farewell is necessary before you can meet again. Every hour spent here was a teachable moment to me. Every day a blessing because it brought forth the chance to make a difference. Respect begets respect. Respect is earned, never imposed. And there was no better way to give respect to my peers and earn theirs than going to work every day well prepared. No bill was too small to be examined.
I tried to speak, I tried to reach out, and that is leadership. You have to reach out and change mindsets. And in the Senate is the greatest place where you can change mindsets. Sometimes you win, sometimes you lose. But the most important thing is you must always make the people win.
Five appointees of President Rodrigo Duterte and three constitutional bodies failed to get the nod of the Commission on Appointments. The ad interim officials whose terms were effectively terminated are COMELEC Chairperson Saidamin Pangarunan, as well as Commissioner George Garcia and Aimee Torrefranca Neri, Civil Service Commission Chair Carlo Nograles, and Commission on Audit Chair Rizalina Hustol were also bypassed after the CA failed to reach a quorum on Wednesday.
Pwede pa silang ma-appoint.
Ng next administration.
It's the natural thing. Up to the last minute, kala namin may quorum, tapos nawala ang quorum.
Lagi akong handa sa isang kaso. So pinaghahandaan ko whether win or lose. Ganon din naman dito. So dapat paghandaan mo rin kung makoconfirm ka o hindi.
This gives President-elect Bongbong Marcos a free hand in appointing officials for the vacant posts. Incoming Press Secretary Trixie Cruz Angeles says there's no information yet on whether or not Marcos would appoint the bypassed officials.
We have no information as to whether or not they will be reappointed. We are only appreciative of the gesture that the President-elect's opinion or choices on the officials are taken into consideration.
The Philippine Senate Blue Ribbon Committee on the alleged misuse of pandemic funds fails to reach the plenary before the 18th Congress adjourned. Only 9 senators signed the report, 2 votes short from being sponsored and discussed in the plenary. The others rejected the report over its recommendation to hold President Rodrigo Duterte liable for the government's supposedly anomalous deal with the medical supplier, formerly.
Ang akin lang naman, kilala niya, eh, siya nag-appoint. Hindi sapat po yan sa akin, pananaw, sa akin lang po. Uh-huh. Nakasama po si President Duterte as nakasuhan sa plunder. Uh-huh. Pero all of them, lahat na executives ng formerly, okay ako kasuhan.
Marami doon na I agree, no? For example, yung sa executives and family. Pero may mga bagay doon na hindi rin ako nag-agree. Tulad nga yung kay President Duterte. Because sa akin pag-analyze, the same, no? Association. At hindi naman, walang evidence na nag-utos siya na gawin ito. So because of that, I am not signing on.
Opposition Senator Risa Hontiveros plans to file a resolution to reopen the formerly investigation in the 19th Congress.
Punong-puno ng mga solidong findings, tatayuan ko rin po yung mga findings na iyon, lalo na po yung sa overpriced pandemic supplies.
Sana i-file na lang natin yung mga ebidensya na yan doon na sa ombudsman para makagalaw na po sila. And we're hoping that this new administration follows through with pwede po yan, continuing investigation.
Meanwhile, outgoing Senate President Vicente Soto III has signed a release order for detained formerly executives in Mohit Targani and Lincoln Ong. Both have been detained at the Pasay City Jail for months after they were cited for contempt for refusing to cooperate in the Senate probe. They are expected to be released this morning.